good morning, AACS community. This morning we are going to continue our tradition of worshiping virtually. And before we get started, I'm going to read a few verses from Romans 8. For I consider that the sufferings of this present time are not worth comparing with the glory that is to be revealed to us. For the creation waits with eager longing for the revealing of the sons of God. For the creation was subject to futility, not willingly, but because of him who subjected it in hope, that the creation itself would be set free from its bondage to corruption and obtain the freedom of the glory of the children of God. For we know that the whole creation has been groaning together in the pains of childbirth until now. And not only creation, but we ourselves, who have the first fruits of the Spirit, groaning inwardly as we wait eagerly for adoptions as sons, the redemption of our bodies. For in this hope we were saved. Now hope that is seen is not hope, for who hopes in what he sees? But if we hope for what we do not see, we wait for it with patience. Likewise, the Spirit helps us in our weakness, for we do not know what to pray for as we ought, but the Spirit himself intercedes for us with groanings too deep for words. And he who searches our hearts knows what is the mind of the Spirit, because the Spirit intercedes for the saints according to the will of God. And my prayer this morning is just that as we continue to wrestle with the uncertainty of this time and this age that we are all in right now, that we will remember that we have an advocate with the Father, the Spirit, who intercedes and prays for us, even when our own prayers are insufficient. And we have a Savior who came and died for us, and we have a God who loves us. And I just hope that this morning is a reminder of that promise, that God is faithful and that he cares for you even when it's uncertain. That's where we get that hope. If it was certain, it wouldn't be hope anymore. That's why it's so important for us to keep holding on to the promises of God even when we don't understand them.